Actually, Sally, it was thought for a while I might be dyslexic.
Who thought that?
I did. Anyway, I know how to spell P-I-S-E-D, and that's what I'm gonna be. Ooh, for a ciggies.
Yeah?
Can I try one?
This looks like quite a techie affair. No wonder poor Tess had her jaw dislocated. That's why Keith insists we holiday in this country. Don't get all the rowdiness.
No. Or any of the fun.
Keith always says, and I've come to agree with him, that anything you can find abroad is right here on our doorstep.
Oh, yeah. Because there's a pyramid at the end of my road, and the Leaning Tower Pisa's by the roundabout.
Pyramids are nothing compared to Chatsworth House. This country has a very rich heritage which we want little Dane to learn about.
Yeah, the slave trade, Northern Ireland.
We won't teach him those bits. We'll take him round the stately homes and the castles. He's already got a very inquiring mind. Keith says he's probably Oxbridge material.
He's not even one yet.
You can see in his eyes. Tess looked down on other babies. They bore him.
Yeah, I can sympathise with that. All my nieces drone on about is Barbie. Now, I know she has an action-packed life with her riding school and her beauty salon, but none of it interests me.
Robin, what is that cack on your face?
It's a skin complaint.
Winnebago.
Impetigo.
Impetigo.
Yeah.
Mind you, when I was a little girl, my uncle brought a souvenir spoon back from Belfast, and all through the sectarian murders and the shopping centres being blown up, I'd think, that's where my spoon came from. Not the exact arcade, I can't be that precise, but the vicinity. It's important to have that link with other countries.
Oh, Sally, guess what you missed while you've been down here?
They've given that tempo marching orders.
They haven't.
No, sadly. But the post has been.
Oh. Ben's back.
No, it's the new temp guy.
Whoa. Yeah, he's pants off. Like Ewan McGregor, but Chinesey.
Where's Ben then?
Who cares? The temp can stay as long as he likes.
God.
Yeah, we need someone decent to look at trudging into this hole every day.
Excuse me, but aren't there double standards at work here? It's fine for you to drool over this young lad, but I'm not allowed to pay the female temp the occasional innocent compliment.
No, you're pervy about it. We just admire from a distance.
No, I'd get close if I got a chance.
Yeah, obviously she would. I've got some self-respect.
I might start posting letters to myself to guarantee a visit.
I gave you that idea. Might as well go and do some work.
Never.
Yeah. I'll just have a coffee first.
Is this the smoking room?
No, love. We're all just wild free thinkers who won't respect authority.
I'm not. So the smoking room is...
Here. This... Is the smoking room?
Gotcha.
Take a pew. Come and join us.
Tell
us all about yourself.
I better go and find Clint. Get him to fix the photocopier. Oops.
Cool. Grim in here, isn't it?
Yes.
No.
It used to be quite oppressive, but they painted it not so long back.
What an icky colour to choose, this murky yellow.
It's beige.
With a hint of a tint. They did tell us what shade it was. Oh, what was it, Barry?
Cream explosion.
Oh, this frigging machine. It's pressed for coffee and it's given me mushroom soup. Oh, but they got the sugar right.
Robin?
Miranda?
Robin!
Miranda!
Rob!
Rand!
Do you two know each other?
Long time no see.
Yeah. So, where are you working these days?
Well, here.
Oh, yeah. You look so different.
Come on, missus. We don't need to trip down memory lane with these two.
So, how do you two know each other?
We were at school together.
She was my girlfriend.
Really?
Yeah, I suppose I was.
Girlfriend?
Yes.
So, how did you and Romeo here get together?
We sat next to each other in chemistry.
Love across the Petri dishes.
Yeah.
And she weren't setting fire to him.
Yeah.
God, Robin, do you remember that girl used to sit further down the bench? She was always sniffing the gas taps.
Wendy Walker. God, that is so weird. I often see her around here.
Never. She doesn't work here.
No. She's a tramp. I see her looking through the bins. Yeah. She hasn't changed. Still wears that Happy Mondays t-shirt. It honks.
It would do.
And do you remember that madman who used to take his photography? He was always going, ah, in the middle of sentences, for like no reason. You know, he'd say, Norway's coastline is typified by, ah, fjords. And we used to call him Mr. Yeah.
As nice as it is for you two to relive your school days, we're more interested in the whole boyfriend-girlfriend thing. So, was Robin your first true love?
No, it wasn't a serious relationship.
Wasn't it?
We only went on a couple of dates.
Three? We went on three.
He took me to see My Own Private Idaho 3 times.
It's pure class, that film.
I used to love all that snogging in the back row of the flicks.
There was none of that.
No shit.
Hello, hello, hello. Have you been to a fair this morning, Rob?
No, I've been in here.
What's with all the face painting shit? Are you a tiger?
No, it's a medical condition.
Is that fake tan? You big girl, it's all orange, man. He looks like an Oompa Loompa.
Clint, this is Miranda.
Hello.
Hi.
Miranda used to be my girlfriend.
No way.
She did.
Briefly. We know each other from school.
When Miranda was my girlfriend.
Briefly.
Respect?
Yes, respect to me for having a glamorous blonde girlfriend.
I wasn't glamorous then.
Then?
I had a bowl cut.
Did you?
So, you're just here to see Rob, yeah?
No, I'm working upstairs. Just temping.
Aww.
Thank God.
I couldn't work here full time. That'd be a real slasher-wrist proposition.
Oh, is that who you're covering for? Tom Manders?
Sorry?
He slashed his wrist.
No, he didn't. He sliced the top of his finger off.
Why?
He was cutting up a butternut squash.
I didn't think he was the suicide-y type.
No. He plays penny whistle in a folk band.
Ah, a fellow performer.
How do you mean?
I did it, Rob. Like I always said I would. I chased my dream.
What, the one about Simon Le Bon?
To be a dancer. I'm dancing now.
Are ya?
I'm even moving into acting.
Never. I thought you'd become a firewoman.
No.
That's what I heard.
I saw a woman set herself on fire once when I was backpacking through Nepal.
Sweet.
Yes, just like that. It was a sort of protest.
Well, maybe that's what I heard.
No, it's never a firewoman. I did loads of boring office jobs, though, in places like this. But if I'd carried on like that, I'd have topped myself by 40. The monotony. The pointlessness. So, jacked it all in, retrained as a dancer, stroke actress.
Good for you.
What's your name, love?
Miranda.
I know that. Miranda what?
Langton. Miranda Langton.
Never heard of you.
Well, I mainly work in the theatre.
Or in places like this.
I couldn't do this full time. Be slave to a wage for most of the year just to buy a week's freedom in the sun.
No. You need at least a fortnight. Don't back her up.
Have you done much acting lately then, friends?
Yes, I've just done a tour of schools with a play about drugs. Knowing E, knowing glue.
I didn't think people still did glue.
Well, we obviously got our message across.
Yeah.
And at Christmas, I did a pantomime.
Oh, no, you didn't?
I did. Mother Goose, up in Crewe. Though I'd like to do some more heavyweight stuff.
Aladdin.
I know what you'd be good in, yeah, Miranda. If they made, like, a film about this Space Queen, Spacerella, she'd be called, or something like that. And even though she's from space, she's not green or with, like, you know. She has got special powers, though. Maybe she DJs, and then one day all these space invaders come down to her planet, but she's all... And then they just go. You'd smash it.
Thank you.
Sorry to rush off, Miranda. Really love to stop and chat. Really love to. Perhaps later in the week. But for now...
Ta-da!
Duty calls. More's the pity.
That's where I'm lucky. I'm passionate about my work.
You enjoy photocopying?
In the theatre, you could hardly call this work. Oh, no. You're the man I bumped into.
Yes.
How embarrassing for you.
For him?
Having to wear those hideous old pants.
Yes, well, all in a day's work.
If you're working with her.
Well, Miranda, I hope to bump into you again.
Try not to.
Just 10 days till I fly off for sea, sand and sex.
I've got 3 weeks till Ibiza. I'm gonna be up there, man, giving it ooh, ooh. No machines or crap to fix. Or, if there are, I won't have to fix them. Just getting it on.
How have you ended up in a place like this with everyone counting the days till they get out?
Getting it on.
Look around you, love. You've ended up here too.
And I don't feel I've ended up anywhere. It's only temporary.
Oh, come on, Robin. You've been here 8 years.
You've got to get out there. Follow your dream.
Miranda, I'm never going to be James Bond. I've accepted it. Apart from anything else, I can't drive. They're not going to have a James Bond who catches buses.
You shouldn't just give up, Rob.
Look, love, you might be happy floating about in a world of make-believe dressing up as Mother Goose.
I was an elf.
But don't look down your nose at us for doing proper jobs.
And working in a place like this has its plus points.
Yeah, loads.
Like what?
So?
Give me a minute.